debate a perfect but more peaceful. I have a wee suggestion to make your day more gleeful. As a general rule of thumb, don't be the first to win the fun with physical force, threats of force, or scamming peaceful people. Non-aggression principles, does this not justify to initiate coercion with force or threats or lies? You'll likely make more friends if you follow it, but if you don't and say you do, you're just a hypocrite. For life to be more fun, we should support the non-aggression principle. Hey!
According to the non-aggression principle, it's not good to initiate coercion.
What's coercion?
Forcing others to do something using physical force, threats of physical force, or fraud.
Physical force?
I'll let this angry cop explain.
Officer Bright Lynch is my name, and I'm above the law. I give the orders and punch you in the jaw. If you disobey me, I'll bind your hands fast, lock you in a cage, and tether you in the air. If you treated anyone as I have treated you, they label you a psycho and use a padded room for some peculiar reason that don't apply to me. Physical force I use, of course, to earn a bloody fee.
Ouch! Physical force is brutal. Attacking others, tying them up, moving them somewhere they don't want to go? That's not nice. What about the threat of physical force?
Agent Extortion works for the IRS, and he can't wait to explain this one.
I'm not going to hurt you, but if you don't comply, I'll get someone who will and get you till you die. Just hand over your income so we can spend the time to piss it all away and send you back some crumbs. I learned from the best, my teacher Al Capone. He's really good at threats and fracturing your bones. It's also called extortion, a mafioso crime. We get away with it while gangsters do the time.
Yikes! So, threat is basically telling someone they better do what you want or else you'll hurt them?
Correctamundo!
So what's fraud?
Lying to benefit yourself or to hurt others. Let's listen to another expert who for once is telling the truth.
Hi, my name is Rizalot. I give my donors rights. I'm paid by clubs and union funds, corporations, banks, and any special interest. Yes, anyone will do. Just get me elected and I'll pass a bill for you. I use all the money that they give to me to broadcast lies for everyone to see. The voters give me power and their taxes too, because I tell them lies. What a bunch of fools.
So fraud is lying to fool others into doing something that benefits you and hurts them?
Exactly.
All these types of coercion are pretty bad.
For life to be more fun, we should support the non-aggression principle. Hey!
Can coercion ever be used in a good way?
Yes, but only for defense. For example, observe.
Any volunteer is living free and having fun, playing on his property, not hurting anyone. Blossom is a bully, she likes to start the fights, initiates coercion with lies and hits and bites. Since she starts the trouble, her behavior isn't good. But Vinny has an option that anybody should. He can use coercion to stop her attack or reclaim what is his. Nothing more than that.
So, according to the non-aggression principle, I should not initiate, or in other words, I should not be the one that starts the coercion. Like Officer Violence, Agent Extortion, Mr. Lysolot, or Blossom. But if someone initiates coercion against me, I can use coercion in response to defend myself, like Vinny.
Precisely.
But why is the non-aggression principle so important?
If we both understand and live by the non-aggression principle, we can make more friends, happily coexist, and cooperate to accomplish great things, instead of being jerks like those guys.
Cool, man.
You wanna sing with me?
You bet your ass I do.
Non-aggression principle says it's not justified to initiate coercion with force or threats or lies. You'll likely make more friends if you follow it. But if you don't, just say you do, you're just a hypocrite. For life to be more fun, we should support the non-aggression principle. Hey!